Have you ever noticed how with your life that you make plans, but oftentimes your plans get a little messed up? I think that's a normal occurrence for most people in their lives, that you have dreams, you have plans, but then they just kind of get messed up. It's in those moments when we realize that our life has gotten more messy than dreamy. I think it's in those moments that we can lean into the voice of God and He can redirect our plans to a better purpose. Just this past Sunday at our church, I preached a message in our series, and it was really all about learning to hear God's voice. And at the end of the service, we had an opportunity where we just put it into practice, stopping, making room, and listening to God. It was unlike any service we had ever done before here at church. And it was different for a couple reasons. One, because we didn't have any worship at all. Leading up to it, right? There was no live music, no live worship. And then I preached, and then we gave a response, and we made room in the service for people to sit and listen to God speak into their lives. And it was pretty powerful in a special way. But that opportunity wasn't necessarily in our original plans. In fact, our plans that we had for that Sunday got messed up. They got messed up because our worship pastor had to go out of town on business because he's bivocational. It got messed up because winter weather caused even the plans that he had for travel to get bumped up even sooner. And so it kind of threw us all for a loop last minute. But what's interesting is that even though our plans were kind of becoming messed up, God redirected them for a greater purpose. And even more so, another layer to this was this message that I preached, God gave me actually 2 weeks ago, and I was going to preach it 2 weeks ago. But then on my typical day of writing and prep is Tuesday, and so I'd finished it all out, and I was about to close up for the day into the afternoon, and I just felt the Spirit prompt me saying, hey, this message, it's not for this coming week, it's actually for 2 weeks from now. And so I stopped and I prayed on it for a little bit, and I really felt like that was the Lord. And so I went back, opened my computer, and I started writing a new sermon for that upcoming Sunday. And I saved that sermon on prayer and hearing God's voice for this past Sunday. And what's interesting is that that sermon was already prepped and ready and well positioned us to have those moments of praying and hearing God. See, my plan got a little bit messed up, but God already knew where I needed to be and what I needed for those moments. He has a way of making a way ahead of time, even when it catches us off guard. I say all that to say this, not to make it sound like, hey, I know how to hear God and you should be more like me. That's not the point. What I'm trying to get at is this, that sometimes your plans seem messy in a moment, but God can reroute and redirect them when you listen to His voice for guidance. God wants to guide you in your life no matter the situation you find yourself in. God has an escape route. God has a rerouting for you. God knows how to GPS you and get you en route to your destiny and your purpose, but it requires you being willing to stop and listen to His voice. God wants to speak to you. And when He does speak to you, His voice and His wisdom will help redirect and direct you even in a messy moment. So I want to encourage you, take some time and ask God to direct your steps this week. And when you do, watch Him reroute you into a better purpose than the plans that you had previously. Hey, that's it for me. Hope this has helped you have faith for today. You're loved.